Welcome at tutorial number 4 of the computer-aided railway modeler called SCARM. In the previous tutorial we created a side track with a few turnouts on our layout. In this tutorial we are going to see how we can easily copy and paste a part of our layout to use it again at another location. Let's open SCARM. And let's click the open file icon to open our tutorial 3 that we saved. Here is the sidetrack with the turnouts that we have, and I would like to create a similar sidetrack over here at the bottom. What I can do is left click and draw a selection box, and it will select all the track inside that box. Right now I would like to copy this selection. The standard Windows command for copy is Ctrl C, and that is in SCARM exactly the same, Ctrl C. No visual, I don't see anything happen, but this selection is now saved to the clipboard. In SCARM the command for paste is similar as the standard window command Ctrl V. There is again not much of a visual, however, I see now a new endpoint here and another new endpoint here. The track, however, has been pasted right over my selection, so if I don't look out then I cannot even see that this is a double track actually at the moment. Let us have a move command, the control key. Keep it pressed, left click and drag, and now I can see it was actually a double track. Let's create a gap over here. I select the straight and hit delete. Right now I can simply double click and it will select all the connected rails. Control left click to move, and when the endpoint start to color I can let go and it will snap. That's all there is to it, it is not more than a 5-second operation. Suppose that I did not want this sidetrack at the inside of the oval, but I wanted it to be at the outside. Well, let us first select it again, and then control left click and move it a little bit again. One might think that what's now needed is a rotate command to rotate it 180 degrees around. However, SCARM does not have a rotate function. There is a simple way to do what we want to do, that is to connect this endpoint to this endpoint, and we will see that it will automatically turn around the whole selection. So let's hit Control key again, left click and drag, and now we wait until the endpoints color and then let go, and the whole selection has turned around automatically. This is how simple it is to copy and paste a piece of track. Let us save file save as, so that we can use this new layout in tutorial number 5, where we are going to see how we can rotate a layout. See you in tutorial number 5.